Welcome, everyone, to our kickoff 75th anniversary celebration hymn festival, The Song Will Go On. This program is inspired by another hymn festival I had the opportunity to collaborate on during my time at Lutheran Summer Music this summer in Valparaiso, Indiana. Amongst the conversations when planning that hymn festival were ideas of time of isolation and regathering as we move through, hopefully, what is the end of this pandemic. We talked about the history of things, the history of song, the history of groups gathering together, and no theme seemed to be more perfect for such a milestone as this 75th anniversary than to also title our program, The Song Goes On. Our song has been sung in Fargo-Moorhead for 75 years, as of last year, we're a year late. But 75 years of music making is a long time to be in a community, especially for an organization as specialized as a group of organists. This evening's program includes a variety of hymnities, some brand new, some familiar tunes, but maybe some new texts, some old favorites with some new arrangements. Some of these arrangements were composed specifically for this event and are dedicated to it. And I hope that you all are able to take away something tonight as we journey through the story of a continuing song, a song that goes on in the world through creation, through solitude, community, faith, peace. A song that goes on through the Red River Valley chapter of the American Guild of Organists, a song that goes on in the community of Fargo-Moorhead. You'll notice throughout the program there aren't instructions for standing up and sitting down. I invite you to stand as you are able at the beginning introduction of each hymn, and you may be seated for the poems and other readings being offered by Pastor Mary this evening. Thank you for being here tonight as we kick off our celebration program here. If you look in your program, there's a little envelope and a little note. We are inviting those, if you like what you see tonight and want more of it or want to be involved in some way, somehow, there's an envelope where you can leave a donation if you wish to the program and also fill out the sheet. There are pencils in the welcome pads in the pews close to the aisle. You can fill out that sheet with some information and we'd be happy to send you some more information about our program. If you look at the sheet, if you donate more than $40, you are able to also register to be a chapter friend of our chapter and receive all kinds of updates and our bi-monthly newsletter, as well as an invitation to be a part of the planning and creating of this program. Thank you this evening for being here, and I hope you enjoy and find something you are looking for in this program. Thank you.
Thank you. God is praised in creation. Around us and in our own being, we have the primary revelation of God. We are surrounded by the primary sacrament, creation itself, an outward sign of an inward grace. The holy writings remind us often of creation's praise of God, but we often do not hear what murmurs and shouts about us. We often do not see. George Eliot mused on this and wrote, "If we had a keen sense of all ordinary human life, it would be like hearing the grass grow or the squirrel's heartbeat, and we should die of the roar which lies on the other side of silence." As it is, the quickest of us walk about well wadded with stupidity. Annie Dillard says we should amass half-dressed in long lines like tribesmen and shake gourds at each other to wake up and see, to wake up and hear the deafening roar of all, of like all of creation, praising God.
Thank you.
Ours is a singing faith. Now hear the hymns we raise, resounding strong the years along and echoing our praise. Ours is a singing faith. In confidence we sing, creation's throne is God's alone, so joyous voices ring. Ours is a singing faith. Through all the ebb and flow of youth and age on history's page, we see saints come and go. Ours is a singing faith. The melody rolls on, sustained by those whose voices rose in praise in times long gone. Ours is a singing faith. Upheld by work and prayer, that justice, peace, and hope not cease, but flourish everywhere. Ours is a singing faith. Though grief or pain hold sway, Christ still shall dwell, Emmanuel, God with us all the way. Ours is a singing faith. All thanks to God be sung by people here, both far and near, in every land and tongue. Ours is a singing faith. Let psalms and anthems rise from sun and moon and stars in tune, till music fills the skies. In early morning, we awaken from the sounds of engines running in the night. And then we start the engines of the day. We speed away into the fading light. Nowhere is any sound but of our going on roads strung everywhere with humming wire. Nowhere is there an end except in smoke. This is the world we have set on fire. This is the promised burning, darkening, our light of hope and putting out the sun, blighting the leaf, the stream, and blessed are the dead who died before this time began. Blessed the dead who have escaped in time the twisted metal and fractured stone, the technobodies of the hopeless cure. Now to the living only grief is shown. The little yellow of the violet, risen again out of the dead year's leaves, and grief alone is measure of the love that only lives by rising out of grace. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards, but many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption in that order, as it is written, "Let the one who boasts boast in the Lord." Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
When music wakes my sleeping heart and plays my spirit strong, then all of life is gracious gift and every breath a song. When music gathers us in prayer and summons us to praise, then beauty spills her shining light across the darkened days. When music calms the fearful heart and lifts the downcast soul, then all our song is healing balm to make the wounded whole. When music fills the universe and all is melody, then Christ the Lord will lead a hymn of soaring majesty. To you all praise, O Holy One, all praise and glory be. Our alleluias without end will ring in harmony.
Thank you.
I know that I have life only insofar as I have love. I have no love except it come from thee. Help me, please, to carry this candle against the wind.
Yeah.
praised in justice. God is praised in lives that live divine compassion, in lives that seek out the God desire rather than the human inclination. God is praised in lives that heal and seek, that rise and care, that hear and see, that risk and call. God is praised in lives that look beyond themselves. There can be no praise without justice. Our songs without justice are an annoying noise. Our hymns without compassion, like the scraping of stones. For praise to be complete, let justice flow. Let justice flow.
Thank you. The Red River Valley Chapter of the American Guild of Organists presents for installation of the following present, duly elected, and appointed officers. Please come forward when your name is called. Dylan J. Swanson, Dean. Alex P. Swanson, Secretary Treasurer. Dr. Jean Helmer, Archivist and Webmaster.
You have been chosen by your colleagues to guide this chapter during the coming year. This selection shows confidence in your wisdom, character, creativity, and leadership.
Will you severally promise to uphold the national bylaws of the American Guild of Organists and honor their enactment? If so respond, I will.
I will.
Will you unite in your common charge as officers to continue the advancement of organ and choral music? If so, respond, I will.
I will.
Will you endeavor to elevate the status of church and temple musicians, encourage continued education, and strive for the enlightenment of the community in which you serve? If so, respond, I will.
I will.
Will you faithfully fulfill the duties of your individual office to the best of your ability? If so, respond, I will.
I will.
Fellow members and gathered community, will you support these officers in their service to the Guild? If so, respond, we will.
We will.
Now that the elected representatives have pledged to serve the purposes of the Guild, you, the membership and General Assembly, have endorsed their leadership. Let us welcome our new chapter officers. Congratulations.
So Michael was my predecessor as dean, and he led the chapter through some really troubled days. And if it wasn't for Michael, a few years back when our chapter was ready to fold in 2016, we would not be here celebrating the 75th anniversary of the Red River Valley Chapter. So we have a little thank you for you, and thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart, and the rest of the officers for believing in the chapter and sticking with us all these years. And just because he's not dean anymore doesn't mean he's going anywhere. We're going to keep a tight hold on you, and we'll keep you involved. So let's give Michael a huge thank you.
We live in a culture full of music. Music is a wonderful gift that God has given us. Music is universal. It can be used to soothe the soul. It is amazing how sometimes when someone is feeling depressed or anxious, a song can lift them up. Whether music for congregational worship resonating through the churches, classrooms, recital halls, be it instrumental or vocal, the study and practice of music holds a unique place in the history of Fargo-Moorhead and the world. Music is capable of expressing a variety of moods and feelings, joy and sorrow, hope and fear, faith and doubt. Making music, sharing music during these challenging and isolating times of pandemic, creates community and connectivity. Today, we offer a prayer for those who make music. Let us pray. God of all creation, whom saints and angels delight in worship, pour out your spirit by your servants, who with the gifts of music enliven our praises and proclaim your word with power. Through this ministry, give us new awareness of your beauty and grace, and join our voices with all the choirs of heaven, both now and forever, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now by the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.